Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. DNC literally suing Trump campaign for conspiracy to help Trump win. They're going to try to prove collusion in court? Clearly frustrated that special counsel Robert Mueller has come up with almost nothing so far to prove the accusation that the President Donald Trump's election campaign colluded with the Russian government to fix the 2016 presidential race. The Democrat National Committee filed a lawsuit Friday aimed at doing Mueller's job for him. It's not likely to end well. In one of the more bizarre twists in the already hopelessly convoluted quest to undo the results of the campaign and undo the Trump presidency, the DNC is asking a federal court to find the Trump campaign engaged in activity to bolster Trump and denigrate the Democratic Party nominee, according to CNBC. Well, as the DNC well knows, bolstering its own candidate and denigrating the other guys is pretty much what a political campaign exists for. The twist here is that the DNC is accusing the Trump campaign of working with agencies within the Russian government to take advantage of hacking operations that targeted DNC computer systems, as well as the group WikiLeaks that published a series of damning emails from the account of Clinton campaign manager John Podesta. According to CNBC, the named defendants in the lawsuit include Trump's son Donald Trump Jr., his son-in-law Jared Kushner, former campaign chief Paul Manafort and campaign official Richard Gates, and Trump ally Roger Stone. Also named is the Russian Federation, the general staff of the Russian Armed Force, a Russian intelligence services hacker known as Gukhifer 2.0, WikiLeaks and its leader Julian Assange, and 10 unidentified people. The brazenness of it is tough to beat. First of all, it was the Democrats' own carelessness that allowed their computers to be hacked in the first place. Second, the DNC's interest in an investigation of the hacking now, 16 months after the election, is a sharp contrast to its refusal to give the FBI access to its computers when it could have mattered. Instead, the DNC stonewalled, as CNN reported in January of 2017, possibly because they didn't want outsiders to see what was really happening in the party. Finally, the DNC can't exactly claim to be the victim because the information that did get out was so damaging. Among other things, it forced the then-chairwoman of the DNC, Florida Representative Debbie Wasserman Schultz, to step down just before party's convention and proved beyond doubt that Clinton's organization had essentially rigged the Democrat primary process, on her way to a general election that the conventional media considered a foregone conclusion. And this is the party that's filed a lawsuit claiming the Trump campaign engaged in a brazen attack on American democracy? The hypocrisy is infuriating. Neither the White House nor the Trump campaign responded to the lawsuit early Friday, according to CNBC, but at least one response isn't hard to guess. Since Trump's upset victory in the early morning of November 9, 2016, and especially since Mueller's appointment in May of last year, the Democrat Party and its media allies and operatives inside the federal government have using the special counsel probe to push the empty theory that the Trump campaign needed Russian help to win the election. Since Mueller's investigation has yet to make a single shred of evidence of that collusion available to the public, which is a pretty good indication it doesn't exist, the DNC is now trying to take its collusion case to court. It's going to have plenty of help from its allies and the media, of course, but if there's nothing there, a court case isn't going to change reality. The lawsuit has already garnered plenty of headlines. Asking for millions of dollars in damages is always eye-catching, and it will give the liberal pundits plenty to gas about. But it's not likely to end well.
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.